Going silly for the west side. You might catch me rolling where the rims rise. Ain't no opposition, I'm the best ride. I might take my CD on a
y'all, thank you so much for tuning back into my channel. So I just want to take this time to say thank you, and I really, really appreciate all the love and support that I've been getting, because sis needs it. But anywho, I'm going to try to make this video a little quick because I got shit to do, and I know y'all do too. But just kind of want to tell y'all what's been going on with me, the things that I've got going on, and just all the beautiful things. Oh, I'm just so excited. But anywho, and then I also want to talk to you about the bath that I posted the other day. I've been getting a lot of questions and comments and things about that. So I just want to come and spread the truth to all my people. But recently, I started a spiritual journey, just trying to become more spiritual. And when I say spiritual, that's exactly what I mean. I don't mean religious, and I have no shade towards any religions. That's just not what's going on with me right now. I mean, you know, I was raised up in the church. My grandma, Big Lou, shout out to her. And also my other grandparents, Hazel and Ernest. I definitely miss y'all too, for sure. I was raised up in the church, always going to church every Sunday with my grandma or whatever she went. You know, I was always right there. And even when I moved down here to Florida, I started visiting a couple different churches, just trying to find that church home, you know. But make a long story short, church has never really been my thing per se. I mean, I don't have any beef towards it, you know. Many peace and blessings to the people that go there and everybody involved, especially if they're about the right thing, because a lot of y'all not, flat out. I mean, but that's just the way of the world. But anywho, it's my song too. So like I said, I've just been on this spiritual journey, just trying to really take time and learn more about myself, the things that I like, things that I love, things that I don't like just really trying to focus on me and my higher self, because I definitely believe in a higher power. I know there's a God. I feel him moving within me. Therefore, I know I am a goddess. That's why I refer to myself as such. A lot of people, I don't take offense when people call me queen. I don't really refer to myself as that, because it is of the world. I know I'm higher than anything in this world. So, but anywho. So like I said, I've just been on a spiritual journey, and I've really, 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 I feel like I found my thing. But like I say, yeah, I tried the church thing. I went to a couple different churches down here. I even went to a white church. Obviously, I couldn't connect with them. Don't get me wrong, the pastor was really, really cool. Shout out to him. You know, he was nice, but I still didn't feel connected. I mean, I'm paying my offering, my tithes, whatever, trying to put time in, coming to little events, whatever. It just, I tried a different church. And with that church, you know, it seemed pretty cool. You know, people stay to themselves, people welcome you, whatever. But I found myself only wanting to go to the church when they were doing like the morning worship. And when it came to reading the Bible and stuff, I would find myself not really connecting. It was so hard. Like, and I remember Big Lou always told me to pray and ask God for wisdom and knowledge. So I used to tell her back in the day, like, I'm trying, I just can't really get into this like you're doing this, like, and I want my blessings too. But I just, and even when I moved to Florida, I met a friend, Tracy. Hey, Tracy. He also even told me, you know, to pray and ask God, you know, to help me understand and things like that. And I still just couldn't really get into it. And I didn't want to just go against anything. So I just was like, you know, it's obviously a different way. So I started doing other little things, started reading, watching, talking to people. And, you know, I found that I'm really into crystals and stones and things like that. Different stones have different properties. One of my favorite stones, I would say, is rose quartz, because I am a lover at heart. And rose quartz, it deals with things like emotion, love, and all that little cute stuff and whatever like that. Another stone that I like is black tourmaline, because it's a protection stone, and it also has a way of like turning all the negative energy positive, if that's making any sense. Like, it absorbs negative energy, breaks it down, and turns it and releases positive energy into the air. That's how I feel, period. So I have my stones with me every day. I don't never leave the house with one. On my work badge, I'll show you real quick. Now, on the back of my work badge, I have this rose quartz stone, and I just wrapped it in a little gold floral wire that I got from the Dollar Tree, Walmart, or something like that. My little fat is just on 10 today. But I'm not no fancy schmancy jewelry artist or anything like that. I just took the wire, cut me a piece off, and just got to wrapping it around, and that's what I came up with. Shout out to me. But yeah, I love rose quartz. So, you know, like I said, I tend to keep that one close by, and the black tourmaline. I love amethyst because that helps with my anxiety, because sometimes I just... But it really helps with my anxiety. I do encourage you all to find something to believe in. There's a time and place for everything. So a lot of y'all seeing me on here calm and all that, just know I'm still e-money from the I still am who I always been, but I do get it. You know, like I said, it's a time and a place for everything. And when I'm by myself, I like to wind down. I don't be on 10 and it's just me in this damn house. So when I'm winding down, I like to do my spiritual baths. That's exactly what that is. And I have different things in there. But I'm going to get to the video so that way you see all the stuff that goes on in there. It's Florida water, herbs, sage, all that. I encourage you all to, in your areas where you live, look up some metaphysical stores, spiritual stores. A lot of the stuff that I get, you obviously can get as well, because it ain't like I went to the ends of the earth to get none of this stuff. If you don't have any medical physical stores in your area, you can Google them online, order stuff offline. But yeah, so I'm just go ahead and show y'all the bath, and that's that. Hey y'all, so getting right into this, I want to let you know that this particular bath is not for bathing, so please do not use any type of soap whatsoever. The first ingredient in my bath is Florida water, which is like a liquid sage, and you can find that at any spiritual store. Then next, I'm just going to put in some pink Himalayan salt. I love that stuff in my bath. Oh my goodness. Now I'm using some healing oil, which is a lavender healing oil, but you can use essential oil if you have it. I just ain't had none. And then next, I'm putting some herbs, rosemary and thyme, which I actually put in at the beginning, so I'm not going to do it right now. And then this mixture is just of like roses and some pretty ass flowers I got from the flower shop, along with some sliced lemons. Like I said, it's roses, and then these other flowers, I don't know, but they were just so pretty and vibrant, like greens and yellows and oranges, and I just really wanted my bath to be pretty and vibrant, so I got those, and you simply cut them off the stems and add them to your bath. And I do have like some healing stones and crystals surrounding my tub, because that's what I'm into. Those things really, really give me the energy and protection that I need. And then I'm also going to light some Palo Santo. Please Google that, because this is something that you want and need, because it keeps out all the negative energy and only brings the positive. And this is something that you might be a little bit familiar with, which is sage. This is my big daddy sage, and I just like to go around my water with that. And then what I'm also going to do is sage myself a little bit, just going around my whole body. And you can do this if you want. You know, you get the gist of that. But yeah, so I like to sage myself. And then I got these floating candles. Make sure you light your candle after you put it in the water, because I lit mine, put it in a tub, and of course it sank to the bottom and went out. But luckily, I got a backup baby, so it ain't nothing. And look at me struggling to light that, but it's all good. I really hope you enjoyed this video, and please stay tuned. And another thing, before you start this bath, you want to take a shower just to make sure that you are fully cleansed, because there is no soap that goes into this bath. Now, this bath is used to cleanse your soul spiritually, but this is not going to clean your body, because we're not using no soap. So please just go and get you some things that may help you relax, whether it's a glass of wine, whatever the case is, but just fall back and relax, baby.